Welcome us all in Jesus' name.
Amen.
The Lord that we have come to meet, we meet us at the point of our needs in Jesus' name.
Amen.
He's the only one that can sort us out. He's the only one that can settle our troubles. And I pray he settle us this morning in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Without wasting much time, I want to thank all of us for your kind gesture. Last week was the Pastor's Appreciation Week. The Central Office sent the information. And honestly, I wouldn't have told you. But one way or the other, somebody got information and sent it across. And I was amazed with what my people did. God will surprise you.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Anytime you put your hands in your pocket, that pocket will not be empty.
Amen.
As you are bringing that one pocket, bringing your hands out, it will be coming out with money.
Amen.
We not lack good things.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Whatsoever you are believing God for, he will do more than that.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
You will not die.
Amen.
Your seed will not die.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
And it shall be well with you.
Amen.
All the days of your life.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
But the story we are hearing all over about the 270-something children is real. And even if you have not got your own child, you need to intercede. Just imagine if you have 4 children and you are going to bed and you have in your heart that 2 of those children are still missing. Can you sleep? May that never be your portion in Jesus'
name. Amen.
Let us, the only thing we can do for them is to pray. If there is a man to pray, there is a God to answer. The Bible says, if my people that are called by my name, who are the people that God is referring to? It's you. He said, if we can humble ourselves and pray, please let us pray. The whole world now stood up for Nigeria. Obama is not in Nigeria. He's in Kenya, America. But the assistance he has given now, may God bless him in Jesus' name. And may God bless all of us in Jesus' name as we intercede. Praise the Lord. Father, we thank you for your word. We bless your name. Father, speak to us in the name of Jesus. Everywhere that we need your attention, Father, pay attention to our problems in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' name, we have prayed. This morning, we are going to talk about divine restoration. Divine restoration. And I take my text from the book of Joel. Joel 2, verse 25. Joel 2, verse 25. And I read, and I will restore to you the years that the locust has eaten, the cankerworm and the caterpillar, and the powerworm, my great army, which I sent among you. Praise the Lord. The Lord will restore you in Jesus' name. Every caterpillar, every cankerworm, every powerworm that he has sent among you, God will restore you back to a new old place in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
What this small verse has told you and I is very deep. If you look at the conclusion, he said, my great army, which I sent among you. What does that tell you? God himself is at work. Because he said he's the one that sent it. But he promised that he will restore. That is why I have titled this divine restoration. What is divine? Divine has to do with God. And restoration means something that is being restored. And I conclude by saying, before restoration, there was a destruction. Is that not the truth? If you look at the Bible, it said, caterpillar, cankerworm, pamper to come into the midst, into our midst. He said, he sent them. It's not the devil now, it is God himself. But he promised that he will restore those years that locust has eaten. Every year that locust has eaten in your life, in your career, The Lord will restore them this morning.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
You cannot argue with God. Amen. You cannot. If I say this from my memory, you can argue. But anything that comes from this world, if you love yourself, don't argue. Because the Bible says God is the word himself. He said, I will restore those years, the years that the locust has eaten. He said he sent them. He sent the locust, he sent the bandworm, he sent the caterworm, he sent caterpillars. So I said, before restoration, there was a destruction. Then the question is, why will God allow his army to be destroyed? Then what happened when there is divine restoration? Because of our time, I just spent about 15 minutes more. You got me? Then when God said restoration, the impossible becomes possible. Remember, he sent them. He created the problem himself for us. But because he said, God, we have suffered for those years, he will restore them back.
Amen.
If you look at the book of Job, Job suffered for 9 months. Who brought the problem? God. God himself was at work. God called Satan, have you considered my servant Job? And the man said, yes, I know. I can't touch him because you have built an edge around him. Permit me, let me not touch him. And God said, go ahead, but don't touch his soul. And God allowed the devil to touch and tormented Job for 9 months. When divine restoration came, God restored Job for 140 years. He suffered for 9 months. And because the word of God is forever settled, he said he will restore. And God restored. And the year that this man suffered, if you compare to the year that he enjoyed, the divine restoration will be amazed. I pray for you this morning. Every year that you have wasted, God will restore them back for you in 100-fold in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
The impossible becomes possible. Look at the story of Sarah. All these stories, you know them. I just picked them. I don't need to be reading the Bible passages for you because you know them. I told them yesterday somewhere. The Bible said about Zechariah. He said Zechariah and his wife Elizabeth. They were both blameless before God. I believe that if anybody is blameless, all his prayers should be answered. Is that not so? But when God is going somewhere, but like one of my brothers said this morning, he said God can do something to bring out something. That's the truth. Both of them are blameless, and the Bible says they are blameless. So if God said somebody is blameless, nobody can change that. But the Bible says at the end of the day, they were both by. Somebody in the Bible says is blameless, and the Bible says they were by. But when God restored those years back, he gave them a gift that money cannot buy. This morning, the gift that money cannot buy, God will give it to Jesus.
Amen.
Sarah, look at the story. The woman was old. If anybody should see an old woman passing by and say, Mama, in the name of Jesus, in the next 9 months, you will carry your child at 90. What do you think the woman will do? The woman will laugh. Honestly. Just go to the sea center. Say, mommy, grandma, how are you? In the next 9 months, you'll be pregnant. The woman will look at you as if are you coming from the womb? That was exactly what happened to Sarah. But because God has said that those years that you have lost, I will restore, that prophecy came to pass. I pray once again, every year, every minute, every hour that you have lost due to your negligence, due to God is going somewhere, God will restore back to you in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
What happens when the restoration comes? The dead will come to life. And I'm not talking of physical death now. We know that when there is a divine restoration, even those who died physically, they come back to life.
The soul of Lazarus told us that.
Jesus deliberately left them alone. We came to him when the man was sick. You know the story.
Sir, your friend, whom thou lovest, is sick.
Because they believe that if the man died, maybe he will not be able to restore. But because Jesus has healed some sick people before, he said, okay, let's allow God to perform another wonder today. He said, I'm back, I'm joining. The first day, the second day, he didn't go. Until the man died. And they gave up. No, it's gone. Do you know that on the fourth day, Jesus had the news again? Oh, this man is dead. Forget about me. I said, he will rise up. But he said, no. I know he will rise up on the last day. Jesus said, no. I'm not talking of that last day. I'm talking of now. And he went to the tomb of Lazarus. Said, Lazarus, come forth. And immediately, the Bible says, him that was tied up and buried came forth. And he came forth with him being tied up. But because that day was the day of his divine restoration, the dead came to life. Everything dead in you, every of your dead career, every of your dead dream, I pray divine restoration for you this morning in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Brethren, the Lord we serve is a mighty God. You know, the bigger your God, the bigger your miracle. When you believe that your God is big, when you tell your friends your miracle, they'll say, no, I can't believe this. But when you look at your God as a small God, when problem comes, then you run to. Many a times, God will allow problems, as we have read in the Bible, 12 to 25. He sent the great hand, he sent the prophet. But he promised that because I'm going somewhere, I will restore you. Many a time, we find ourselves in one or two problems that we don't understand. But because God has a purpose for it, because God wants to glorify himself in that problem, we bring the restoration today in Jesus' name.
Amen.
When there is divine restoration, then the bitterness becomes sweet. Brethren, nobody enjoys problem. Even if, except your spirit. And even spirit, they don't have problem. Nobody. Nobody likes challenges. Nobody likes troubles. Everybody wants to wake up in the morning, go walk, come back home, sleep, praise to God, and wake up again. I want a car, buy it. I want this. That is the life everyone knows. Everybody on the face of the earth, that is the life we want. But there is a way God has to promote us. And if you don't write the exam, there is no promotion. Is that not the truth? You don't. Even in the spiritual realm, Jesus has to come down 7 times for God to lift him up. Jesus himself. He came down 7 times. He humbled himself. He wrote the examination. He never faced the one-on-one. Tempted him. So when you pass through any temptation, just rejoice. If Jesus can be tempted, I will be tempted. You will be tempted. It's not a loss. If Jesus was tried, I will be tried. And he will be tried too. The Bible says, count it all joy when you pass through diverse temptations. Diverse, it doesn't mean one. Many. So when you just come out of one, rejoice and prepare another. Brethren, in time of peace, prepare for war. We have problem now in Nigeria. Obama said he's sending his people. Do you think they just prepare that when the problem started? No. They have prepared their soldiers. In case there's any problem in anywhere in the world, we are going to send this help. So they are already on standby. So it is during your peace period that is when you prepare for war. It is truly when you are enjoying the goodness of God. Prepare that in case this happens, what will I do? Because if you come, don't let any pastor deceive you. But the joy I always have is that if you come and you go, every problem you've passed through, every problem you are passing through is just a passing phase. Recording said, When you pass through it, don't hold it. When you go, when you are going through it, don't stop. Go ahead. But you woke up one day and cried. Say, God, today something must be done. You that can open the Red Sea, you can sort my problem out. But you call upon the God of Israel. God of Israel, I want to change my name. I want to restore me. Remember this boy didn't cry at the age of 10, 15. Maybe he was 20 when he cried. But between 1 and 20 years old, he was living in sorrow. But God restored you. The Lord has restored Jabez, we restore you in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Now you must discover the root of your problem and deal with it. Why did I have this problem? If you want to be true to yourself, you must be able to sit down. This is the problem I'm facing. Why? The Bible says, he that covereth his sin will not prosper. I didn't say it. And prosperity is not about money alone. When we are talking of real prosperity, it's not money at all. He said, he that covereth his sin, black and white, will not prosper. Proverbs 28:13. But he that confesseth and forsaketh, you can confess and think over, you will not prosper. But when you confess and run away from it, that is where you can have mercy. So don't read the Bible halfway. Don't say, after I confess. No. The God we have is the God of details. This is how I want it. Yes, sir. You do it the way you want it, you rejoice. The Lord will help us in Jesus' name. The Lord will help us in Jesus' name. Colossians 1 verse 20. Colossians 1, 20, 20, 24. Colossians 1, 20 to 24. The Bible says, and having made peace through the blood of his cross, by him to reconcile all things unto himself, by him I say, whether they be things in earth or in heaven, and you that were sometimes alienated and enemies in your mind by wicked works, yet now are they reconciled in the body of his flesh through death, to present you holy and unblameable and unreprovable in his sight. If ye continue in faith, granted and settled, and do not move away from the hope of the gospel, which ye have had, and which was preached to every creature, which is under heaven, whereof I bore and made a minister, who now rejoices in my suffering, for you and fill up that which is behind of afflictions of Christ in my body, say, which is the church. Praise the name of the Lord. Praise the name of the Lord. Whether you like it or not, when God is ready to restore you, there is nothing the enemy can do. No. When God is ready to visit you, somebody told me a story where I went yesterday in Reading. And he said, you know what happened? He said, I should use that testimony to go and encourage someone. He said, if God can settle her in this land, there is nothing God can do. He said, he came to the country 12 years ago. She said when she was coming, she came with somebody's passport. Her sister, who loves her so much, just brought her to this country. And when they got to Heathrow, he said that Heathrow, they discovered that passport is not her own. They stopped her. He said, because of ours, the immigration officer came and said, we know that this passport is not yours, but there's nothing we can do for you. You can go. As if that was not enough, he came to the country, he was looking for jobs all over. The passport is not a home, that's not a real name, but it's a real passport. Eventually, a time came when she just got, now she made something. She said, when she came in, she removed her shoes and walked over the land. I said, God, you said, wherever my soul of my feet, my soul shall touch, you have given it to me as an inheritance. The way I came in does not matter. You brought me here. I tell you the truth. Say, the way I came in does not matter. You are the one who brought me here. The way you are going to say to me, I don't know. And she was fighting the battle. She was fighting the battle. When God wanted to say to this lady, she said she has tried all she could, and she failed. And she was looking for her husband. She said the husband she met was God sent. He said, I didn't need to go and ask anything.
He said, because the problem she has been facing for years, the name she has been using for years, looking for how she can. Do you know that she used that passport to go to university in this country? Another person, identity. She graduated with that name, but she was still troubled. No, this is not my name. And she met a man. And they applied now with her real name. And in February, she was giving the ability to do. I said, what? He said, so, he said, there is nothing God cannot do. He said, problem? He said, let problem go. He said, I will stand before the problem and say, you, my God will solve you. And that challenged my faith. The sermon we hear at church is not to hear it say, it's to hear it and apply it to our situation. Say, God, you can do that, sister, that I've had that testimony. My home will not be possible. And your own will not be impossible for God in Jesus' name.
Amen.
I say your own will not be impossible in Jesus' name.
Amen.
When there is divine restoration, there will be divine reconciliation. When God restores you, there will be God reconciliation. So this morning, I want you to stand up and say, Father, wherever I have missed this, reconcile me back to you. Stand up, pray to God, say, Father, wherever I have missed it, that has put me in this, Lord, reconcile me with yourself in the name of Jesus. Without the reconciliation, there is nothing I can do. So, Almighty God, reconcile me with yourself in the mighty name of Jesus. My Father, I pray to you this morning. There is nothing you cannot do. You are the God of all flesh. The Bible says our God is God of all flesh. There is nothing too hard for him to do. If you stand impossible in your faith, it may sound impossible to your hearing, but God can do all things in the name of Jesus. There is divine restoration coming your way this morning in the name of Jesus. God will restore you permanently and he will restore you completely in the name of Jesus. Almighty God, I pray this morning that anyone of us that needs divine restoration will restore us in the name of Jesus. Thank you, our Father. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. You are going to pray for your lost. Yes. Father, every year that I have lost, restore me back in 100-fold. Pray every year, Father, that I have lost, restore me back in 100-fold. In the name of Jesus, Almighty God, every star that I have prayed, every year that I have lost, that is restore me back in the name of Jesus. Restore me back in the mighty name of Jesus. Restore me back in the mighty name of Jesus. There was a woman who was asking God for a husband. She was married for years, no child. For years. And she was growing 41, 42, 44. You know what God did? For God to restore all those years back. The first pregnancy she has 5 children. One, just one. To prove to you that God can restore. Every year that is wasted, God said, don't worry. 5 are the first to go. To shame them. So we are going to pray, say, Father, every year that I have lost in my career, in my family, in my matrimonial home, restore me back in 100-fold. Pray in the name of Jesus. Almighty God, every year that I have lost in my life, in my career, in my home, in my ministry, in my ministry, in 100-fold, restore me back. Thank you, Jesus. No one like you. Truly, you can do all things. Father, we pray this morning, every year that we have lost, Father, restore us back.
Amen.
Restore us back.
Amen.
Restore us back.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Thank you, our Father. In Jesus' mighty name we are praying.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. Let us have a seat for this one final announcement.